Hey guys, welcome back to our channel. Hope that you guys are doing absolutely fine. So in this video, there was a lot of questions and a lot of comments and a lot of suggestions from you guys, like not only you, from my family and colleagues, that we have a ultimate weapon in our hands and in our pockets and we use them very often, right? So I thought, why won't we give it a try and give you some tips and hacks how to get the most out of your smartphone. So today in my hands I have my Realme XT, which there is also the unboxed video on my channel. So I'll be throwing the link in the I button, which is being popped up over there right now. So before getting into the video, I would like to tell some specifications of my mobile. So Realme XT comes with the quad camera setup. The primary camera, it has of 64 megapixel, 12 megapixel, 8 megapixel and 2 megapixel. So each one has some different features and different unique options, and the front camera is about 16 megapixel. So Realme XT has greater saturation level when compared to the smartphone retailers which are actually in the competition of the flagship mobiles, like we know OnePlus 6, OnePlus 7 and so on and so forth, right? But I didn't like OnePlus because the Snapdragon is okay, but actually I wanna get the mobile for main purpose was to get the better camera quality, and then the second consideration was gaming. So as I told, my first consideration was the camera, so I went for the Realme XT. I have compared with the other flagships when it was launched, and it cost was around 20,000, and then I have compared it with the OnePlus 7, which were on the flagship when this mobile was launched in India. And there was also one Realme 5, Realme X and Realme XT finally. So after relating all the options, I went for a Realme XT. It is helping me in taking the broad range of photography, and I'm using it since almost all 4 to 6 months, and I have got full hands-on review in it, and I will give you some greater tips for it. So most of you camera not on Realme XT, so I'll be talking about the all the general mobiles. So the all mobiles will be having some video mode, short video mode, time lapse mode, photo mode, portrait mode, and also the pro mode, which is very specific. And for Realme XT, which has a 64 megapixel camera, there will be 64 megapixel mode. So these are the different options, and there are also slow motion and so on and so forth options. So it would be rather we shift on to the main content which we are going to record in this video. So we grab the mobile and is presently in the photo mode. So you can see backside of me, there are lots and lots of trees and so much of greenery. So I'm going to take some good advantage of the greenery and outdoor. Firstly, we have different modes, right? So we'll firstly go through the photo mode and portrait, then pro, then whatever the modes, ultra, like ultra macro, so on and so forth. So you can also buy some lenses. I will be throwing the links in the description below, and I will quickly go through some of the lenses in Amazon and Flipkart that are available at the enormous size. So we'll use the photo mode right now. So there is a small bush kind of plant. So I'm gonna take this as a reference because the color of this is very lightweight and we can edit them easily. So while taking the photos, you have to keep in mind that while you are going for the editing purpose, then you have to make sure you have some good editing software. So guys, as you are watching on the screen, there will be the common modes like the flash, like HDR. So HDR will be auto, off and on position. So if you are going to select the flash to the on position, then you cannot opt the HDR. So then you have to go for the auto mode on HDR, then auto mode on flash, then both will work. As if the lighting is low, then the HDR will be turning off and the flash will be using. And if the lighting is high, the flash will be turning off and HDR mode will be turning on. But I don't want to take photos in the night time. So I'll be simply shifting towards the HDR one, which absolutely gives you some stunning pics. You can see the leaves are so, the blending effect has been coming into the frame. And you can see how clearly we can see the leaves. And there's also the chroma boost feature, which is available on the Realme XT. I don't think which is available on the other smartphone. As I said, the saturation levels in Realme is very good when compared to the flagship mobiles, which are in the competition with the Realme. So when we on the chroma boost, the photo will be like this. So so I will taking two photos, the one with the chroma boost off and on. So we'll quickly compare both of them. So this is the photo which is which has been taken when the chroma boost is turned on, and this is the one which is taken when the chroma boost is turned off. So you can see the very little difference, but that little difference makes a lot of sense. When you want to be a natural photographer or else nature photographer or the only photography which you want to make, you're gonna take some outdoor shoot like plants, rocks, pebbles, oceans, seas, so on and so forth, and lakes, so then you have to use the saturation level because it will enlight your mobile and enlight the photos. And there are also n number of filters, so I'll just we'll take something different. So we'll again take the same papaya tree leaf. So okay, there are some mini papayas which are popping out. So we'll take that as a reference. So this is a papaya, and we'll apply some filters right now. So you can see how the filter is changing. This is the R1 filter, this is R2. So you can actually have some great effects by shifting the filters. This is the complete black and white filter. So there are n number of different filters, you know. But I choose the original one, and I'll choose the R1 only when it is necessary, because you can see the saturation is very good and the natural color is coming onto your screen, and you can capture all the natural color. So I'll turn on the turning off all the filters right now, and just use the, and also if you have some, we have some different options, right? Like a full frame, 4:3 ratio, 1:1 ratio, and the full frame. But I always use a full frame, and my regular settings will be as same. I will use the grid because the grid will help you a lot. So whenever you wanna whichever phone it might be, so you always have the grid option. So just turning on the grid will make a lot of sense, and you can see the 3x3 grid is turned on. In some phone it will be 6x4, 6x6, and so on and so forth. N number of options are available. Different number of settings, right? Like location, shutter sound, grid, watermark, and artificial scene recognition. This is the one of the most handiest feature which is available on the smartphones which are coming into market right now. Because it will actually, when you are making some point, then it is showing that the green plants, right? See, you can see on the screen, it is showing the green plants. So it is also a basic feature which will help you a lot. So we will take the papaya photo again in this photo mode. So we have another papaya. So make sure your mobile is stable, and as I turned on the grid, you can see 3x3 grid, right? So using the 3x3 grid, the simple way is that make sure your photo, thing which you are gonna take the photo, make sure it places in between the middle most row of the grid. I mean the middle most row, this is one. 1, 2, 3. So if you are gonna take some landscape photo, then you have to cover all the 9 grids. If you are taking in the horizontal position, then you have to make sure you use only these three grids to make the things into a focus. So guys, so we will look into the portrait effect right now. So actually I thought of sitting down rather than standing up, because I can have a lot more information. It will not be sufficient if I am gonna roam here and there. So I thought of sitting at one place. So our primary object right now will be this tree or the tree. So if we are gonna consider this tree as a object, so I'm clearing some branches so that leaves, it will not come into our way. So talking regarding, now you can see the portrait effect on my camera, sorry, on my mobile phone camera. So if you are gonna focus on this leaf, it will not be focusing because the leaf is too thin to focus. And again, I'm using the grid, which is very useful. I'm again telling you, please go if you want to have some great photos from your mobile. Then you have to make sure you use the grid, which is the option available from your settings. So from down you can see the effect. If these branches are cut off, then it will be more looking more great. And again, we have some n number of filters, you can use any of it. And this is a black and white, this is something else, neon, which it is a full saturation. What is this? This is completely background. So I'm using the original filter. I'm relying on the Snapseed, which is giving some good option for me, and it is helping a lot. And it can be simply we can edit the photos with a click of the button. So this is the portrait mode. So you can see the blurry effect, but I don't like the portrait mode like such. If not, you can have, as I mentioned, you have some different kinds of lenses which are available on Amazon and Flipkart. And the difference between the photo mode and portrait mode is that portrait mode blurs the background even more than the photo mode. And then here goes the 64 megapixel mode, which is available on Realme XT and Realme X series, I mean the X2 XT, and if I'm not wrong, on the 5 also. So talking regarding 64 megapixel, it captures a lot of information. And presently this sun is getting down, it's about 6 p.m. on right now. So we'll take a single shot with the 64 megapixel and we'll compare both the normal photo and 64 megapixel photo. So we are taking a 64 megapixel photo right now, and I'm moving on to the photo section and taking the same photo. So this is the normal photo and this is a 64 megapixel photo. Will not be seeing much difference, but when you are gonna zoom in, you will see a lot of difference. This has been taken from 64 megapixel one, and this has been taken from the 16 megapixel one. So you can see a lot of difference, right? So when you are gonna zoom in, the image gets pixelated, and in 64, even if you zoom in or crop, the quality is good. You can see right over here, and in 60 normal photo, you cannot zoom in much, so it will pixelated even more and it becomes choppy. And the last mode I'm going to talk is the Pro mode and Ultra Micro mode. So Pro Expert mode is very good when you have a full grip on your mobile, and you can see you have EV option, auto focusing option, the shutter rate, the ISO, and the lighting rate. This is also known as the bulb. So it is a blue bulb right now, and this is a fully saturated like the sunset. And so in Pro mode, I like the most because it gives you complete control on your camera. So we'll take the autofocus for now. So this is completely manual focus. So okay, you can see a lot of difference right now, right? So we'll increase this to 0, which is giving a good exposure, and you can see the focus. So before taking, you use the 5x. So we have three different options again on the Pro mode, like 1x, 2x and 5x. I don't know whether the same option is available on all other mobiles also. So on Realme, I'm using the 5x to just adjust the focus on the plan until you're seeing the picture in a good quality, and take it back to 1x if you're using the manual focus only, it is for. And then use the WB and set the color. Use this only for saturation, it will be good. And if you're gonna shoot in night, then the white side will be good, about the 2000 Kelvin lighting will be good. And if you're shooting in the daylight, the range should be between 4000 to 5500 Kelvin, such that the photo will be very crisp, in the daylight shooting. And the other main thing, shutter speed. If you're gonna use the highest shutter speed, the shutter speed is nothing but how much amount of time, how much amount of light is entering into your lens. So if you're using the 16 seconds, the how much light is entering into your lens, you can see. The best option is use 1/20th or 1/25th shutter speed. It's of good quality. Or else you can just take it to the 1/250th shutter and leave it, and then take your photo. So this is the expert mode photo, and we'll quickly take another photo from the normal mode, and we'll compare them both. So guys, this is the normal mode. This is the photo taken in normal mode, and this is the photo taken in the Pro mode. You can see, you can zoom in how much ever you want, but the picture quality is not gonna degrade and the picture is not gonna get pixelated. That is the main important thing which I like about the Pro mode. And it so better you take some time, learn the techniques, and use the best of your photo by using the Pro mode.
Last but not the least, the ultra macro mode. For this, I'm going to change the subject to other thing. So guys, as you can see, the phone, it is showing that best quality will be given when you are facing the camera at the camera from the object at the 4 cm range. So this is a very small object. So for ultra macro, I'm using this small object. So main thing is, do not cover the light. I mean the natural light, don't cover the natural light from obstructing. Like if I'm gonna place the hand, you cannot see the beauty of the plant, and if you're gonna remove the hand, then you can see the, even you can see the seeds which are present inside the plant. So you can see the photo, it is pixelated because the camera is of only 2 megapixels. So I'll take another shot, we'll make sure this time it will be of good quality. So I'll just turn on the light. As almost all the macro lenses which are, if I'm gonna take the lens for the Canon M50, there is a lens of 22mm of aperture f2 and f2 or 3.5. It has a light as such as my camera, and the closest range is of about only 4 cm for almost all the lenses. So I'm just gonna use the flash and take the photo again, such that if I'm gonna just place my hand again, also the light is not obstructing because I have used the torch light to fill the light in it. So let's take a look at the second picture. So second picture also not giving us the great, but when compared to first one, the filling using torch giving us a better quality. So
these are the n number of options which are available on the camera and the photo on the camera, and there are also the slow motion time lapse and panorama. So for time lapse, I'm gonna make another video because time lapse is the most, it gives out the most beautiful content of the sunset or the sunrise, which is at the extreme level. So guys, as you've seen in the video, these are the tips and hacks to get the best out of your weapon, which is known as a mobile phone, which is nowadays common in almost all the pockets. So guys, if you like the content of my video, then go and like this video and hit the subscribe button and smash the bell button so that it rings away. Thank you very much for watching. See you next video with another cool and great stuff. Till then, bye bye, take care, stay at home, stay safe. Goodbye.